And I believe that they have the capacity to see the truth and seek it, and then work with the other Nigerians of, you know, who have this positive ideas about moving this country forward.
All right, I'm just wondering, because you said the number of times now that NIM is going to, you haven't started. You know, but that those who are there who say, wait a minute, you've got less than a year to achieve some of these things, and people want to know what is the option. So if you, can you achieve all of this in less than a year or whenever you start to finish?
Well, as I say, it's a giant task. It's something that we are progressing as we go along. NIM is actually unfolding, as it were. And it has to concern even gentlemen like yourselves who are out there.
So he can't contest?
None that he can contest. Well, now, we haven't got you to contest. We're coming to enlighten
him. Okay, he has to be part of the...
Yeah, the press is very much a part of the progress. You know, the way that you report instances, the way that you package the whole idea of, you know, the community called Nigeria, and the positiveness that you bring to it.
Is this about 2019?
Well, 2019, as you rightly know, is a very short time. But we intend to do the best that we can to galvanize opinion and peoples, especially in the area of voter registration.
Good. Okay, go ahead.
You said something earlier, and I'm kind of concerned. When you said to enlighten, to bring in intellectualism.
Yes.
Are you not breaking up the populace? I mean, you're trying to move the elite away from those who are not so enlightened. Is that not what you're trying to do?
No. I'm talking about some kind of renaissance, a timeout. You know, we all understand what the issues are. We can see it in our daily lives. You know, the poverty on the street. You know, all of the different issues that are afflicting Nigeria. It's all very, you know, out there. Okay, so basically, how do you propel mindsets, you know, to shift? And let's see each other for who we are. We're better than this. We can do a whole lot better. Nigeria has people in and out of, there's a major brain drain. Most of our Nigerians are living outside the country and they're performing excellently.
Let me jump in.
Please.
What kind of challenge is NIM going to envisage from our literacy level? How do you convince people to do something that is good for them if they can't see it, if they're hungry?
That's another good question. But, you know, we still have to continue to do the work. And especially, that's why it's very critical. Because that's the set of people that we're talking about. The hungry masses. How do you bring them back to normalcy? So that everybody and all hands are on deck. We need to build this country. You know, we're not building it. You know, we're destroying it right now.
You know, people are also concerned because when you talk about how rich the country is, how diverse, how much we are in this country.
Absolutely.
And we look very recently at how INEC is battling with an extra 30 political parties that are registered.
Yes.
Have you factored in the probability that we may have another coalition movement coming side by side, and I am?
Well, there's a whole lot of movements that are out there, okay? Now, how do you galvanize all of this movement to become one major movement?
Is that what you're doing?
Well, no, we're standing alone as it is, but we're trying to, what's the word? We're trying to bring people on board with us of like minds and mindsets. You know, people who will understand that it's, at the end of the day, it is how we project ourselves and our country. It's the same way that we'll be received anywhere else. Now, you just go back a few months ago or so when we were called the asshole word, you know? Why do we get called that kind of name? How do we begin to process it so that we get out of that mind or that kind of stigma, if you want?
So what's your message about voter education?
Well, besides voter education, voter registration, because the election is very close by. We need to expand voter registration. We have to have more and more Nigerians. I mean, imagine that 15% of Nigerians were the ones that put this government in power. So what happened to the rest of the 85%?
How do you become a NIM member?
It's open. It's very open. It's on. It's online.
Do you have a card like the APC has?
No, no. We're formulating those policies as we go along. Right now, it's all in a process of unfolding process. You are invited onto the platform, variously from all across the country, north, south, east, and west. Everybody is, and it's a oncoming on train, if you want. It's building up. Okay, and we want to put it out there that, you know, that's the option. That's the third option.
What about funding? What's the thinking of NEEM about funding?
Well, we have our Department of Finance, who would most likely throw more light on the financing side of this, of NEEM. But if you ask me, it would be like the Obama way of doing things. People just have to ante up, you know, whatever little that any Nigerian... Yeah.